In this video, I explain accumulator circuit for hydraulic press machine. So in this image you see this is the hydraulic press machine, it's punch and dies. So earlier we study about the hydraulic press machine, that in which we use the dual pump. One pump is small size and the big size. Okay, but if we use the accumulator circuits in hydraulic press machines, we are avoid the use of the one pump. Okay, so that reduce the initial cost. So how it's working, that we discuss in these videos, and what are the advantages of the accumulator circuit compared to the dual pump hydraulic circuits. So first I explain you what is the accumulators. So accumulator you already study in a fluid mechanics subjects. In a hydraulic devices you are studying the various device, okay, and out of that one is the accumulators. The hydraulic accumulator is a device used for store the energy of liquid in a form of pressure energy, means it is used to store the liquid with pressure energy, and this energy may be supplied it for any sudden or intermediate requirements. Okay, so this is the basic of the accumulators. So in this diagram you see here we install the accumulators, okay, and other part is same as the hydraulic press machines. So here this is a punch holder and punch, sheet metal, die and die holder. Sheet metal means it is workpiece. So punch is connected with this double acting cylinder. Double acting cylinder is connected with 4x2 directional control valves. P pot is connected with this pump. P pot is connected with these reservoirs, and this is the inner component, that is the pressure relief valves. Okay, and oil coming out from the pump is supplied it to the P pots. Okay, and in between this pump and P pots we install the accumulators to store the energy. When the energy is not required to this double acting cylinder, at that time we store the oil in a accumulators. The figure show a hydraulic press circuit in which accumulator is used to save the power and to avoid the overheating of the working fluids. So these are the main thing of to use the accumulator. First is to save the power, and second one is to avoid the overheating of the working fluids. In a normal position, spool of 4x2 DCV, pot P is connected with the pot B and pot A is connected with this pot T. That means they are talking about the second square of this directional control valves. Okay, so this second square is considered as the normal positions. So here you see this cross line is drawn. Cross line is drawn means the P pot is connected with B pot. Means on a left side, first pot is the P pot, and the left bottom P pot, right bottom, that is the T pots, and the top left A pot and the top right B pots. P pot is connected with this B and A is connected with this T. Hence the cylinder is retract positions and the punch is in the topmost positions. Means when the oil from the pump is supplied to the P pot, and from P it is supplied to the B, and B it is supplied to the rod end pot, and this oil is applied the some force on the piston in upper direction, and piston is moving in upper direction. It is called as the retractions, and with this piston the punch is also moving in a upper directions, and sometimes the piston is reached to the topmost position. When this piston is reached to the topmost positions inside the cylinder, at that time the punch is also reached to the topmost positions. When we press the lever of 4x2 DCV, oil under the pressures flow from P to A and B to T. Means when the piston is reached on the topmost positions, we need to change to the second positions. Okay, and this operator is moved his levers, and the P pot is connected with A and B is connected with this T. Hence the piston of double acting cylinder is extends. Means when the oil from the pump is supplied to P pot, from the P it is supplied to A pot, and from the A pot it is supplied to this cap end pot, and this oil is applied some force in the downward directions, and the piston is moving in downward direction. So with the piston, pump punch is also moving in downward direction. So it is called as the retractions. Okay, sorry, it is called as the extensions of the cylinders, and the punch is moving downward to punch the sheet metal workpiece. After punching, we leave the lever of 4x2 DCV. It is the spring ridden type, hence it will be come back to its normal position. Means when the extension is over, we need to leave the 4x2 directional control valves, and it's spring ridden type. So here you see the spring is provided, that means it is a spring ridden types, hence it will be come back to its normal positions. In a normal positions, oil is flow from P to B and A to T, that we already discussed. Here you see in these normal positions. Okay. Hence the pistons of the DSA is retract, punches move in upper directions and stay in the retract positions until the wall is pressed against. Now before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to the OHP and other subject of the mechanical engineering. For the OHP, various link is provided in descriptions as well as in a card mean on top right screen of your mobiles, you see the eye symbols. And for more subject, I request to visit the playlist. Punching stroke and the return stroke take very less time, happen within the seconds. Punching stroke means when the punch is moving in a top to bottom, it is called as the punching stroke, because at that time they perform the operations on the sheet metals. Return stroke means when the punch is moving in a bottom to top directions. Okay, so this punching stroke and the return stroke is take the very less times and happen within a seconds. But after finish the work on the workpiece is to be removed and we need to place the new workpiece to be the mounted on the die, and this is called as the loading and unloading of the workpiece. Okay, so this punching and the return stroke is very quick, but in between the punching stroke and the return strokes, we need to remove the sheet metals and we need to place the new sheet metals on the die. This is called as the loading and unloading, and it required more times. Means we need to stop the piston on the topmost positions. So loading and unloading consume a considerable amount of the time, and it is called as the idle periods, because the cylinder is idle during these times. Okay, why it is called idle period? Because at that time machine is not performing any work, because when we need to change the sheet metals, means when we do the loading and unloading, we require lots of times, and for that times the we need to hold the punch on the top positions. And when we hold the punch on the top positions, the pumping of the pump is continuously start, so they are consuming the power, but we need to save the powers. Okay, for that we need to use the accumulators. Means when the loading and unloading is going on during the idle periods, system does not need the oil, because cylinder is stationary, and oil delivered by the small pump is collected and stored in accumulators at the required pressures. So when this oil is not required in accumulator, means in double acting cylinders, we store that much of the oil in accumulators. Means we are avoiding to use of the two pump. In a dual pump circuit we studied that for the hydraulic press we required two machines, sorry, two pump. Okay, because during the punching operation we required a higher force, and during the idle period we are required a lower pressures. Means idle period means in that case not idle period, but it is called as the during moment in upper directions. Okay, so accumulator avoids the need of a big pump. A small pump can be used, and the discharge of the small pump can be collected and stored in accumulators to high pressures. So achievement of using accumulators in hydraulic circuits are following. So cost of the pump is reduced, small pump cost is less. So we not need to use the big pump in this accumulator circuit, so we are able to save the cost of the pump. Power consumption is less, small pump consume the less powers. We are not use the big pump, that's power is also reduced. Power loss during idle period is eliminated to the greater extent. Overheating of the oil is avoided. So these are the various advantages. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to the OHP as well as the another subject of the mechanical engineering, and share with your